Hello everyone, this is Petko Aleksandrov and today I'm recording an update video regarding the historical data in AI Studio because we have something new and quite useful, and that is the premium data. So the premium data is a good solution for everyone who starts to use AI Studio but doesn't have enough bars on MetaTrader, because probably you have noticed that when you install for a first time the MetaTrader, the brokers do not offer many bars, and this makes it hard to generate robust strategies or to do a complete backtest to see how the strategy performs during the last few years. So the premium data was developed by the Forex Software Company, which has developed AI Studio initially. And the data is really nice for a few reasons. First, it offers many symbols. So you can see there are many currency pairs. And then we have oil, we have Bitcoin, we have a few indexes, gold, silver, and I believe more will be added. Second, this data updates automatically in AI Studio, so you don't need to export it from somewhere or download it from somewhere. Daily you will see the data updated, and today is 15th of September 2020, so I have fresh data until the moment. And third, this data was converted from ticks, so it's a complete data, okay? The ticks were converted to bars, and we have a very complete data. If I go to data and I go to data statistics, you will see that I have missing days of just 2 days. And if I compare it with any of the other data that I have, you will see that it's much better and complete data. Okay, there are no missing gaps such as days, weeks, or months. Sometimes with the others, we have even months missing and we cannot do really anything to fill that data. But from Forex Software, they did their best to create the algorithm which fulfills these gaps, and the data is absolutely complete. So let's run the reactor now with the premium data, and I will run it for euro dollar on H1 chart. Strategy properties, I will keep it as always from 10 to 100. And then I will use acceptance criteria. Let's say I will have a minimum profit factor of 1.2. And I will require a minimum count of trades 300. All right, I go back to the generator and I will click on start. It will take some time for the generator to find strategies, but you can see the speed over this data is really, really quick. And I already have some strategies, so that's another update that we have recently. You can see the new strategy, how better it is from the previous one, and the changes and the backtest output, something really cool. It stays for 5 seconds and then the old one disappears. All right, so we already have some strategies that look pretty good actually, especially this one. You can see that recently does great profit. So I will stop this generator. I will go to any of the strategies. Let's take the first one. And this is a strategy for euro dollar on H1 chart, and it's with the premium data. Now let's change it to MetaTrader demo, or this is the data from GFD. Let's see the difference. Did you notice? A very small difference. Okay, one more time, I will switch to premium data. Here it is. And I switch to GFD. Here it is. All right, so you see that even I use the premium data, the backtest is almost the same as the backtest if I wanted to use the GFD data, which simply means that I can use the premium data in AI Studio and these strategies would be fine to be traded on GFD. Okay, so if you want to use the premium data, the best thing you can do is just to generate strategies with the premium data and then import the historical data from your broker. But if you have less bars, let's say you have 12,000 bars, which is just fine. Here you can see that I have limited about 2 years of data. If I go to data horizon, you will see that I have 2 years and 1 month of data. So make sure you select the same period from data horizon, let's say the last 2 years. And when you have ready strategies from the generator, just click on any of the strategies and change from the premium data to your data from your broker, and you will see if there will be a huge difference or not. Now, if there is difference, what you can do is go to tools and click on symbol settings. From here, you can modify the data, okay? So for example, you'll see that for euro dollar on MetaTrader demo, I have swap long of -5.36, swap short of 0.05, and with the premium data on euro dollar, I have negative swap of 2 for long and short, and probably this is from where I got the difference in the backtest. But if you see bigger difference, you can just change here the values. All you need to do, let's say your broker is Pepperstone, and you just click on it on the symbol that you want to trade with. You can change the premium data to fit with your broker. You need to see these values from your broker. How you can do that is if you go to your MetaTrader platform and you select the symbol, right click over it and go to specification. And then here you can see how much is the swap long, swap short. And as well, here we have the spread, which is just on the right side of the ask price. If you don't see it, all you need to do is right click over the market watch and select spread. So you will see how much is the spread for the assets on your broker. Okay. And then you go to tools, you click on symbol settings, you select the premium data, you go to custom symbol settings and you change these values so they will be the same as with your broker. Then you're ready to go and just generate strategies using the premium data, okay? And that's a great solution for the historical data, because so far what we were doing is to leave MetaTrader open to collect bars, but I know that this takes time, okay, months, even years to collect data for the higher time frames like H1, H4, or even daily. But now we have the data, it's a lot of data, and it's complete. For example, if I go to H1 and I go to data horizon, and I uncheck that, you can see that I have 200,000 bars. And if I go to the generator, how many I have? I have 85,000. Which is data from 2007. Yeah, so all the data in the premium data is from 1st of January 2007. This is for the higher time frames, and for the lower time frames like M1, it's limited to the 200,000, okay, which is just more than enough. All right, if I go through the time frames, you will see that on M15 I have 200,000 bars, on M30 I have 171,000 bars, and this is since 1st of January 2007, so this is more than 13 years, almost 14 years now of historical data, which is one more time just enough. Okay, so go ahead and test the premium data. It's a great solution. If you're just starting and you don't have enough bars with your broker, you just use the premium data on EA Studio and you will see that it works great. All right, guys, thank you very much for watching. This was an update about the premium data that I hope it will be useful to you. And I will see you in the next video. Bye.